Today we are discussing about the brief discussion of a thermal properties of matter. Okay, thermal properties of matter. Now we are discussing about the important formulas and important topics that today we are discussing about by this the total chapter. Now here the first we are discussing about the different types of scales of temperature. Different types of scales of temperature. Now here the scales of temperature, the each scale having the two points are there. One is there the lower fixed point and another one is there the upper fixed point. So one is have the lower fixed point, another one is the upper fixed point. The every scale having the two points, this lower fixed point is called as the ice point. Lower fixed point is called as the ice point. And upper fixed point is called as steam point. Upper fixed point is also called as steam point. Now ice is nothing but is the zero, and upper is nothing but the last of the scale of the measurement, that is called also steam point. Now we discuss the how many types are there. The basically we have the five types of the scales of temperature is there. The first one is the Celsius scale. The first one is the Celsius scale. The second one have the Fahrenheit scale. Now third one is there Kelvin scale, and fourth one is the Reimer scale, and the fifth one is the Rankine scale. Now individually discussing about the first one we discussing about the Celsius scale. Celsius scale. What is discussing by here the Celsius scale. Now in Celsius scale is equal to, the Celsius scale is equal to scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. So what is the Celsius scale is equal to scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. Now this Celsius scale, the CS is the Celsius scale. The scale is denoted by the C because of Celsius denoted by C, minus this lower fixed point will be the 0 by upper fixed point is the 100, that is also is called the steam point, and minus lower fixed point is there the 0. See, this is the scale of a Celsius. Now the second one is then Fahrenheit scale. What is the other Fahrenheit scale? See, now this Fahrenheit scale is equal to scale, again the same formula, scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. What is the Fahrenheit scale is equal to scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. We can write here that is equal to scale is equal to Fahrenheit, the Fahrenheit is written by the F, minus the lower fixed point is there 32 by upper fixed point is there 212 minus 32, the degrees of Fahrenheit. Now this is the formula for the Fahrenheit scale. Now next we are discussing about here the third one is there Kelvin scale. See, third one is there Kelvin scale. Now the Kelvin scale is equal to again the scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. Upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. Now we can write this is equal to also scale. Scale is denoted by the K. The Kelvin is denoted by the K. Minus lower fixed point, that is the 273.15 Kelvin, divided by upper fixed point is there 273.15 minus 273.15 minus 273 minus 15. This is the Kelvin scale. Now next the fourth one is there Reimer scale. See, what is the other Reimer See, this is a Riemann scale. Now this Riemann scale is equal, again you can write a formula, scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. See, right here the scale is given by the R minus lower fixed point is the 0 and upper fixed point is the 80 minus 0. This is the Riemann scale. And the last one is then Rankine scale. Rankine scale. Now Rankine scale is equal to, again we can write the formula, scale minus lower fixed point by upper fixed point minus lower fixed point. See that you can write the Rankine scale. Rankine scale is equal to, the ranking is given by the RA minus 492 by 672 minus 492. 672 minus 492. See, this is the five scales of the formula. Then we can find the in general relation between okay all scales. See, write the first one. What is the Celsius scale? The Celsius scale has the C minus 0 by 100 minus 0 is equal. And Fahrenheit scale, what is the other? F minus 32 by 180 minus 32 is equal. And Kelvin scale, K minus 273.15 by 373.15 minus 273.15 is equal. And here is the Riemann scale. The Riemann scale is R minus 0 by 80 minus 0. That is equal. Rankine scale, how much is it? RA minus 492 by 672 minus 492. See, this is the relation. Now you want any one of the two relations. For example, Celsius and Fahrenheit. We take this is the two equations. And now we want the relation between the Fahrenheit scale and Kelvin scale. Then take this two one. And we want also the relation between the Kelvin scale and Riemann scale. We take these two equations. And we want the Celsius and Rankine scale. We take this two one of the equation. Now any one of the two equations we want, the conversion of Celsius into Fahrenheit, then we take these two equations. Or Fahrenheit is converted to the Celsius, also we take the two equations here. But the Celsius is converted to the Kelvin, then we take these two equations. And also we can write this in the extension. The C minus is equal to C by 100 is equal to, here say the F minus 32 by, sir, actually this is 2 to n, is nothing but 180. 2 to n minus is the 180. Is equal to Fk minus 273.15 divided by, how much is this? 100 is equal to here R by 80 is equal to Ra minus 492 by 180. See, this is the relation of the five scales of the equations. You want any one, the Celsius to Fahrenheit, take this two one. And Fahrenheit is converted to the Kelvin, take these two equations. Now the Kelvin is converted to the Riemann, we take these two one. Any two one, we want to take in these equations. See, the next we are discussing the other topic is different types of thermometers. Different types of thermometers. Now here the basically we are discussing about the four types of thermometers are there. The first one is the liquid thermometer. What is it? The liquid thermometer. The second one is the constant volume gas thermometer. The third one is the constant pressure gas thermometer. Now the fourth one is the resistance thermometer. Now how many is there? The four is there. The first one is the liquid thermometer, and the second one is the constant volume gas thermometer, and third one constant pressure gas thermometer, and fourth one resistance thermometer. Now the individual we're discussing about this topic. The first one, liquid thermometer. What is that discussing by the liquid thermometer? The increasing in value the increasing in value of a mercury in a glass tube is directly proportional to the increasing in temperature. For example, so this is considered the glass tube. So this is considered the glass tube. Okay, now inside we take a mercury. This is the mercury. What is taken by this again? Mercury. Now, when we are temperature is applied to this glass tube, the temperature applied is nothing but now it's a heat is supplied to this glass tube. Now, inner of the mercury absorbing of that heat and it is rising in a glass tube. Rising means its height will be, length will be increasing. Now, that increasing in temperature, its length will be also increasing. The temperature T is equal, what is the formula? T is equal LT, LT minus L naught by L 100 minus L naught into 100 degree centigrade. LT, LT is nothing but to the temperature, the length, at T degrees of temperature, LT is nothing but the length at T degree temperature of a glass tube. And next, L naught, is the length, at 0 degree centigrade, L 100, is the length, at 100 degree centigrade, Here the LT is nothing but what is it? The length of the T degree temperature. And L naught is nothing but is the length at 0 degree. Now in the 0 degree centigrade, the tube in mercury, how much of the length is there? This is denoted by the L naught. At 100 degree centigrade, that denoted by the L 100. That increasing of temperature formula, what is it? T is equal to LT minus L naught by L 100 minus L naught into 100 degree centigrade. This is the liquid thermometer of the formula. See the second one, the constant value gas thermometer. The constant value means here say the to increasing the pressure of a gas at constant value, is directly proportional to its temperature. The T is equal to Pt minus P naught by P100 minus P naught into 100 degree centigrade. And again here the Pt is nothing but to pressure at T degree centigrade, and P naught pressure at 0 degree centigrade, P100 the pressure at 100 degree centigrade. See, this is the formula for the constant value of gas thermometer. In constant value means which will be increasing by there? The pressure can be increasing is directly proportional to its temperature. See, that is the formula for it. Next, third one, what is the constant pressure gas thermometer. See, again, it is the reverse. See that if the volume of the gas increased, at constant pressure, is directly proportional to its temperature. The T is equal to Vt minus V naught by V100 minus V naught into 100 degree centigrade. Here the V is nothing but the value. Now can write the Vt is equal to value at T degree centigrade. V0 is nothing but value at 0 degree centigrade. V100, what is the value at 100 degree centigrade. Now observing that both the formulas are will be same. In this one, what is the pressure is will be increasing is directly proportional to temperature, but take a constant value. But in this one, the value will be increasing. Value will be increasing is directly proportional to temperature, but constant pressure. See, this is the constant pressure of gas thermometer per formula. Fourth one, the resistance in thermometer. So what is the last one is the resistance in thermometer. The increasing in resistance of platinum wire is directly proportional to increasing its temperature. See, that is the formula. T is equal RT minus R naught by R100 minus R naught into 100 degree centigrade. 100 degree centigrade. RT is nothing but resistance at T degree centigrade, and R naught resistance at 0 degree centigrade, R100 resistance at 100 degree centigrade. Now observing for the all thermometers, how many is there? The four thermometers. So first one I have the liquid thermometer, the second one I have at constant value of thermometer, and third one at constant pressure of a thermometer, and fourth one is there resistance thermometer. In this all will be there the same formula, but what is there here? One placed by the R, L and V and P, that is the difference we can observing for the all equations will be same. This will be